Hi, I'm Vince DelGobbo, and I'm a developer at SAS. I started using SAS in the early 1980s and have been working at SAS since the early 1990s. Some of you might know me from my work over the past 20 years or so with integrating SAS output with Microsoft Office products. But you might be surprised to find out that during that same period of time, I've also been involved in developing technologies that enable you to web-enable your SAS code. In SAS 9, the technologies are SAS stored processes and the SAS Internet Application Dispatcher. And in SAS Viya, the technology is SAS Compute Server Jobs. Today we're going to talk about running your SAS code from the web using SAS Viya Compute Server Jobs. The goal of this presentation is to show you how to execute your existing or new SAS code from a non-SAS client. By non-SAS client, I mean a client application that you do not get from SAS and has no SAS software requirement, such as a web browser. In contrast, examples of SAS clients are applications that you get from SAS, like SAS Enterprise Guide or the SAS Windowing System, sometimes referred to as SAS Display Manager. More specifically, you can use any client application or programming language to execute your SAS code as long as that client can open an HTTP connection. This is because the code is executed by accessing a URL. As you will see shortly, the process is similar to calling a web-based service. You can specify the URL in the address bar of a web browser or in any other applications listed here. The only SAS software requirement is that SAS Viya must be licensed on the server machine. The technology used in SAS Viya is similar to SAS 9 stored processes and the SAS Internet Application Dispatcher. And much of what is covered in this presentation also applies to those SAS technologies. We'll start with existing SAS code and then go through the steps needed to execute it from the web. Two macro variables are defined and then used in the PROC SQL code to select specific records from the sashelp.cars dataset. The subset of the data is stored in the work.cars dataset. The macro variables are also used in the title that precedes the output. The sgplot and means procedures use the subset of data that was stored in the work.cars dataset. Here are the results of running the existing SAS code from a SAS client, such as Enterprise Guide or the SAS Windowing System. Note that the PROC means output is to the right of the chart, because I moved it there so that it will enable you to see the entire output in a single slide. The means procedure output appears below the chart when you run the SAS code. Here's an overview of the steps needed to web-enable any SAS code. We use the SAS job execution web application to create a compute server job and then add existing or new SAS code to the job. After saving the job, view the properties to get the URL for the execution, and then use the execution URL in a web or other client to execute the job on the compute server. Our existing code uses %let statements to specify hard-coded program input. You can, instead, use an HTML user interface to collect input from the user at runtime and pass that input to your program as global macro variables. This eliminates the need for hard coding the input data using %let statements. We won't have time to show the steps to do this, but they are covered in detail in the documentation. You begin by accessing the SAS job execution web application using your web browser, available at the address shown here. Navigate to a folder location to store the job. Then select New File and specify a name and optional description. We specify Automotive Compute Server Job for the name. Accept the default values for the other fields in the dialog, and then press OK. Edit the file and then specify the exact SAS code shown earlier. No changes to the code are needed. Select Save, and then exit the Editor tab. Select Properties, then Details, and locate the execution URL in the Job Submit section of the Properties dialog. This is the URL that you use to execute the job. The fully qualified URL contains the server address, and the program, underscore program, URL parameter specifies the URL encoded location and the name of your job. Note that space characters in the job name have been encoded as %20. Copy the URL. Now you are ready to execute your SAS code using only a web browser client. Paste the URL into the address bar of your web browser. The code executes and the results are the same as what we saw earlier when the code was executed using the SAS client. Again, the PROC means output appears to the right of the chart because I moved it there so you can see it all on one slide. Here are some other ways to use the execution URL in your applications. We saw that you can paste the URL into the web browser address bar to execute your code. You can also paste the URL into the body of an email message, and the recipient can select the URL to execute your code. You can add a link to a web page that executes the job when the link is selected. If you have a dashboard or third-party application that supports the iframe tag, then you can use the URL to incorporate SAS results in that application. You can use the URL in an image tag if your SAS program generates only image output. Refer to the return GChart image output and the return SGplot image output samples in the documentation for more details. Many JavaScript applications accept CSV or JSON data format. You can write a SAS program that creates and returns data in the appropriate format, and then use the program as a data provider to the JavaScript application. You can also use the execution URL to include your program results in SAS Visual Analytics reports. Here we're looking at a SAS Visual Analytics report that contains a list table object on the left side sourced with filtered data from the SAS Help Cars dataset. On the right side is a SAS Visual Analytics web content object. We specified the job execution URL and the properties for this object so that the code was executed and the results displayed. These are just a few ways that you can use the job execution web application to web enable your SAS code. Here's a summary of what we just learned. You can use the SAS job execution web application, included with SAS Viya, to author and execute your SAS code from non-SAS clients. A common non-SAS client is an ordinary web browser. We didn't have time to cover this, but mentioned that you can create a user interface to collect input from the user at runtime and pass the input to your SAS code as global macro variables. Refer to the documentation for details and for samples of doing this. You can use the execution URL in HTML tags and also with JavaScript libraries, allowing you to build robust web applications. And we saw that you can include real-time results from executing your SAS code in SAS Visual Analytics reports by using the web content container. Here's a link to the most current documentation for the SAS job execution web application and also my contact information. Thank you so much for watching this presentation, and thank you for using SAS.